within one strategy?
Actually, that came in place or with the, you know, that the main factor here was, I think, President, when he took over, that as he mentioned, his main challenge was to bring peace. So for that, when he, in 2005 November, he was elected, he studied the whole process, of course, with the help of intelligence agencies, heads of defense forces, and also he studied why, for the, you know, the factors affecting why he, the this was finished over 30 years. There were various reasons, and in his defense policy, he answered all these questions one by one, and then he implemented this policy. I think that was the main reason getting all these. You could see the army was doing well, the navy was doing well, air force was doing well, the police was doing well, intelligence agencies were doing well, and the civil defense force was doing well. So all these defense agencies, everyone was doing well within this period. Now how could it happen? Because that they were given clear aim, and this, that aim was maintained throughout, and there was a clear policy. And for example, that I think Shalindra will agree with me, one of the main factors that why we couldn't finish this war the last 30 years was the numbers involved in defense services, whether it's army, navy, air force. And one of the main factors why we could do this time was the increase of the strength of the military. Now, the strength of the military, or, you know, their numbers and how many battalions, how many brigades, how many divisions, or similarly what strength of the navy or the air force, all this, you know, only the president can decide, because defense forces means that has a power. You train them, you give weapons, and it is only the head of state who was elected by the people can decide this, the strength of the military. I'm sure during the last so many years, a lot of commanders have asked to increase me, not by, you know, small numbers, by, you know, effective manner. Now this same question came this time, and, you know, we had four presidents previously, about eight governments, and why most of these leaders did not that take decision was, you know, there were various reasons, but mostly some leaders thought, if we expand the military to this extent, can our economy sustain that? Or sometimes they thought, okay, we expand the army or the navy and the three services like this, what are we going to do after the war is finished? Therefore, they was not increased. Or sometimes they may have thought that there could be a military coup, so they may have not. So for some reason, this vital decision, crucial decision, was not taken. But the president was very, you know, focused. His main thing was to finish this. Therefore, when he expanded, you don't believe. When he took over, I think the strength of the army was about 100,000. Now it is nearly 200,000. The police was expanded by 35,000. and the army, the navy and air force was increased similar. Every month we recruited 5,000 people for the three services. Every month for continuously for 3.5 years. So very boldly he took that decision. I think because I know when I was in the army, he was my adjutant one time, company commander, and many times one operation, that fort operation I can remember, within 1 hour I lost 92 soldiers, within 1 hour by crossing that lagoon to capture the fort. But after that, for so many years, I had to operate minus that number. But asking, this time we had lost, not only we gave all these, you know, the people who got injured, got killed, got deserted, but more than that, we increased the strength tremendously. I'm sure that, you know, ATT couldn't realize how to counter this. And if you can remember that many people, once we cleared the Eastern Province, even the opposition blamed us. And also even ATT said this was a tactical withdrawal. It's true, they thought that, okay, we will withdraw and like previously we can come back. So, but this time they couldn't do that because we put more people into the Eastern Province. Maybe it's not from only the army. You know, the navy was holding the ground. The air force were inside jungle. The police, STF, everybody was there. So they couldn't come back and destabilize the Eastern Province. So that was a main, by, you know, studying all the factors which were affecting the war effort, and studying why we couldn't finish this for so many years. Even the Indian factor, consider the Indian factor. It's a very important to know that why we couldn't finish this at, in 1987, the, you know, the peacekeeping force, Indian peace force. And even after that many times, the influence, that, you know, we have so many powerful countries in this world, but it is only India can influence any military operation in Sri Lanka because of various factors, the proximity of the country, you know, the powerful nation with a big military, only 28 miles apart, 60 million Tamil people in Tamil Nadu. Because of this, it's only India can militarily do certain things in Sri Lanka. President knew this, you know, he saw how was India putting pressure on us at various times. But he tackled India very tactfully. For example, he introduced this system that he appointed Sri Ratunga, myself, and Mr. Basil Rajapaksa to discuss with their officials from that side any issue we could solve between no time. To give an example, just before Indian elections, there was a problem, and you know that Mr. Shivashankar Menon called me at about 4:30. Just like that, he called me on my cell phone and said, Gota, there is a problem. There's a serious issue here. So I said, what? And he said, we want to come and discuss. We want to meet president. He said, give me 5 minutes. I called president. And he said, okay, tell them to come tonight. I called him back and said, okay, you can come tonight. It is 10 minutes the whole thing was arranged. They started from 11 o'clock, 5 o'clock in the morning they were here. They met the president. The president discussed the whole problem and solved the issue. And they went back happily, and Mr. Karunanidhi stopped his fasting and the problem was solved. Now look, if we had waited to happen this through the normal channel, it had taken 3-4 days and the whole situation maybe had been out of control. But you know, he studied all these problems and put solutions to each and every problem. He's, you know, that